for those who had power over our military know that they made a conscious decision that led to the chaotic and frantic withdrawal from Afghanistan. For the Secretary of Defense, General Austin, the head of the Joint Chiefs of Staff, General Milley, to say that they're satisfied with the withdrawal of our troops is nothing short of disgusting and ignorant.
That is Gold Star Father Darren Hoover, who lost his only son, Marine Staff Sergeant Darren Taylor Hoover, at Kabul Airport.
And this week and the next, marking 2 years since the botched Afghanistan withdrawal claimed the lives of 13 U.S. service members, families and Americans still searching for accountability after the effective handover of control back to the Taliban.
Again, the 13 service members who lost their lives on your screen. It's several injured, by the way, in this too. But back in June, Biden's own State Department releasing a scathing 87-page report on what happened, emphasizing the major failures in leadership. Darren Hoover, the one you saw, that's the father of the Marine Staff Sergeant Darren Taylor Hoover, who was killed during the suicide bombing attack in Kabul. Darren, thanks so much for coming on. So sorry to hear again about your loss. We wanted to take this time, if we can, to honor your son in this moment. Can you tell us about Taylor? And then also talk about, again, you and other family members stepping up, voicing, again, your emotion during this time.
Yeah, I appreciate you having me on. Taylor was the epitome of a man's man. Loving, caring, faithful leader. Loved his family very immensely and fiercely. Loved his Marines even more, if that's possible. And wanted to be a Marine from a young age. The big anti-bully, if he saw somebody getting picked on, and he was a bigger kid all throughout his school years, he'd go over and take care of it. And that just showed the measure of the man that he became, that he made of himself. And, you know, over the past couple of weeks, we've had congressman stepping up to help us try and get some of those answers. I can't speak for the other families, although they are hurting and mourning as we come up on the 2 year anniversary here in a week, that something needs to be done. And these people need to be held accountable for the absolute travesty of a botched withdrawal that these kids were a part of.
Thank you, Darren, for sharing the story of your son and for coming on today and expressing what you're going through, because we can't even imagine sort of the pain that you must be feeling and experiencing. And I wanted to ask you, you know, we've heard so many times from those in this administration, the Biden administration, claim that President Biden has empathy towards the American public. Have you received the support you need from this administration in regards to addressing the death of your son?
No, there's not been any empathy. There's been nothing. He hasn't even said their names, let alone shown any empathy or anything else towards any of our family members. There's been zero, just like there's been zero accountability. They don't care. They seemingly don't care. And, you know, it's up to us as family and up to us as Americans to hold these guys' feet to the fire and make sure that their names are spoken of it with dignity and with respect.
And many Americans side with you on that, and obviously translators in Afghanistan, those that were stuck there for quite some time, those that remain stuck in that area under the control of the Taliban. There was a moment yesterday, so much so that you would know this, that this was called out on social media. It was a moment where President Biden essentially was touting the success of this administration. And many, when they heard it, they called out the withdrawal from Afghanistan online. Listen to this moment. We'll get your response.
Name me a single objective we've ever set out to accomplish that we've failed on. Name me one. in all of our history, not one.
Mr. Hoover, can you name one?
I can name 13. In all honesty, I can name 13. And if I kept going, there would be 45 injured. And, you know, the rest of the Afghan citizens that were killed, that was extremely tone deaf and disrespectful as all get out. It just goes further to what I said. There's no empathy. There's no nothing coming from this president or this administration. And like I said before, last Monday, when we were in California, they need to resign. They need to be done.
You know, when you think about those who are willing to defend and fight for this country, your son Taylor was one of them, right? He was able to risk his own life to defend our nation and our freedoms. What's your message to young men and women who might be in similar situations right now? Do you have any sort of message to them, what you want to say at this point when maybe they're losing hope in their top leaders?
You know, I've thought about that a lot, and I've been asked that question. It talks to the integrity and patriotism of our young men and women that are willing to step up, and it says a lot about them. I would caution them at this point with this administration to be careful and to make sure that this is truly what they want to do at this time. You know, if they put it off for maybe a year and a half until something new comes in to take their place, then by all means. But if they're dead set on it, I will support them and be grateful for them that they're willing to sign on that dotted line to protect the freedoms that we enjoy in this great United States.
Well, Mr. Hoover, our hearts go out to you even hearing about this again 2 years later. We know no time will go by to ever remove that pain that you feel for the loss of your son. But just know that he is a hero. He was always a hero. When we appreciate more than anything his service to the United States of America. That is Darren Hoover joining us. We appreciate that.
Thank you, sir.
Stay with us. We'll be right back.